Bande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Bande Radhika Charanodayam Gopijana Samayuktam Bindavanam Manohar Vāñśā kalpataru asyaki pāsindhu bevacha Patitānaṁ pāvanebha vaiṣṇavebhyo namo namah Mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ pangung langhaiti girin Yatki pātam haṁg bandhi paramānanda mādho Vṛndāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasacha Shna bhakti pade devi satva vattvai namo namah Narayana namaskritta naranchaiva narottamam Devin swaraswati vyasam tato jayo mudire Sankirtane krishna katho padeshe Gauriya patrasya prakasane cha Sadanurakta guru bhakti yukto Bhakti pramodakshya jagod varanya Dhayam sada paribhavagnam avishchaduham Tethas padam siva virenchinutam saranyam Vitatiham panatopal bhavadiputam Bande mahapurushate charanarvindam Yat pāda pallavanaka chandamani chatāya Visvarujita gamapikabhavadu svadarshi Purnānurāgrasa sāgara sāramurti Sārādhikāmai kadākipāṁ karvasa Sī Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunittānanda Sī Advaita Gadādhara Sivasadī Gaura Bhaktavinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānu lambita bhujau kanukā budhātu Saṅkītanai kapitaru kamalāyutākṣu Vīśām varu dijavaru jugadharma pālau Bande yagat priyakaru karunā bhatāru Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura surair vandito dibha rupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavan rupe na sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano Priyamananga Madhapaharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagisha Jashwabhadane Lakshmir Yasracha Vakshashi Jasyasthi Hide Sambhid Pam Nishinamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Krishna. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Jada Brahmam, Brahmam, Hari Rasad Galo, Hari Rasad Galo, Vishnava Janam, Kadachit Sangpasvam Stadanu Gamani, Shadruchi Yataha, Tada Krishna Britta Tejati Sanakair, Maikadasam, Sarupam Vibhrano, Bimalarasabhagam Sakurute, Jada Brahmam, Brahmam, Hari Rasad Galad, Hari Rasagalad, Vaishnava Janam, Jada Brahmam, Brahmam, Hari Rasagalad, Vaishnava Janam, Kadachit Sangpashvam Stadanugamani, Shadiruchi Yutaha, Tada Krishna Britta, Tejati Sanakoir Maikadasam, Sarupam Vibhrano Vimalarasa Bhagam Sakurute. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Jagat Guru told that we can only believe a pure Vaishnava. Only we can trust a pure Vaishnava, there is no problem. But if we are going to believe even demigods, that is also a big problem. What to speak about common people? So, Gauriya Goshtipati, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, only and only we can believe a pure Vaishnava. Only. Nobody else. Even we cannot believe Krishna. Krishna can cheat also. So, we should understand the gravity of this, you know, saying. Actually, Bhaddajiva is full of dissatisfaction. There is so much pain inside heart because they cannot understand what is Hari Bhakti. That is why they are feeling pain. Bonded soul, when they can harmonize their own personal desire, everything, expectation, desire, everything with the desire of pure Vaishnava or Supreme Lord, same thing, then they can feel satisfaction. Aprakita Sukhanubhuti. It is called transcendental bliss. Until and unless bonded soul cannot harmonize their personal desire, everything, expectation with Supreme Lord, I mean pure Guru Vaishnava, never they can feel satisfaction. Countless desire, dissatisfaction, expectation, different kind of anartha actually contaminated, totally contaminated. So Prabhupada speaking heavily that there is one and a single, you know, problem. If we can solve this problem, then all other problems can be, you know, eliminated. What is that problem? Prabhupada speaking, all the problem, all countless problem that is happening with one single point. That is called adhakshaja seva. Adhakshaja seva. Aprakito adhakshaja seva. This word making all confusion. Those sahajiya, they are following their own track. Aul, Baul, Karta, Bhajan, all different branches of, you know, they all demand that we are also doing bhajan. Okay, you are going to follow your own track as you can, as you like. Prabhupada speaking, the same single point. Nobody tried to explain this point from heart under the guidance of previous Guru Varga. Nobody liked to explain. Because if adhakshaja seva, this term is clarified, clear, and who can do seva? I mean, without Vaishnava, nobody can do seva. And what is the quality of that Vaishnava? Automatically coming, chain-wise. Prabhupada speaking, this adhakshaja seva, this term is making confusion, all problem, is the root cause of all problem. Nobody like to get solution of this problem. That is the main. Adakshaja seva, how to do, who can do, and this is the main problem. And Prabhupada speaking, automatically another chain wise, another problem coming. Another problem is very vital point, Prabhupada speaking. It is the main problem actually happening in the society. I already told previously, those Mayavadis, they are getting entry into in a devotional field to make contamination. It is different thing. But what Prabhupada speaking now is that without approaching a pure Guru Vaishnava, without achieving the Bhagyan, we are going to declare that our Diksha done. Prabhupada speaking, this is the root cause of all garbage increasing. In the name of Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha and of preaching, all dirty garbage we are accumulating all over the world. Prabhupada speaking, is a root cause. Without approaching a pure Shuddha Guru Vaishnava, without getting the Bhagyan from a genuine source, we are going to declare that we have received Diksha. How long? Well, 30 years back, Diksha. Prabhupada speaking, you have received Diksha 30 years over, but why the Bhagyan you are not getting still today? Why you are not going to get Dibbogyan? What to speak about Dibbogyan? Common sense. Kandogyan in Bengali we say. Common sense also not coming. The how we can say? I already told. If you allow me to serve a thief, then I can develop my character accordingly. If you allow me to serve a demigod, I can get quality accordingly. If you allow me to serve a Pandit Bhakti, material Pandit, I can get quality accordingly. If you allow me to serve him. But the case of Ramanujacharya was totally different. Ramanujacharya, Lakshman Desik went there in front of Jadavacharya, because that time it was Shankar Sampradaya was so influenced, so powerful. And nobody can think otherwise. So you are bound to go to get Vedanta Tattva Gyan, but Ramanujacharya is the eternal person of Supreme Lord. So there was no problem. He was serving Gurudev, Jadavacharya, while messaging. But Acharya, Ramanujacharya is not a man-made Acharya. It's eternal Acharya. How you can understand who is eternal Acharya? Automatically, Baba speaking, all eternal qualities of Acharyas coming inside him, all Siddhanta Vichar, everything, then manifested, you can get manifested in. Ramanujacharya was not made Acharya that time. But automatically he is speaking all pure Siddhanta in front of Jadavacharya. So this way actually, that was special case. So Lakshman Desik, Ramanujacharya went to serve Jadavacharya to get the knowledge of Vedantogyan. But Ramanujacharya was successful to initiate him ultimately. You go through the life history, I already told Tattva Siddhanta of Ramanujacharya. And also, day after tomorrow, we should have a special discussion. What is that discussion? Both Bhaktivinoda Thakur, both Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, both of them are Tathacharya. Tathacharya. But the speciality is there to understand the Tattva Siddhanta of Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, we must go through Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is the heading of next discussion. 30th. So you see what I mean to say, that if you allow me to serve a cheater, a characterless person, you can test it. If you think, if you express doubt, you can test it yourself. If you are going to serve a cheater, you can develop that kind of. If you are going to serve a characterless person, you can develop that. So my point is that what I mean to say, what Prabhupada wanted to say, that if at all I am going to serve a pure Sadguru Vaishnava, then why that kind of mood, that kind of feeling not coming inside me? My diksha is over, but still today I am not feeling any urgency to serve Supreme Lord. Somehow I am doing tilak mala, everything, but somehow, but I am not feeling 100% it is urgent to do Hari Bhajan. My life is going, our life is going, you know, this feeling not coming. This feeling not coming, why? We already have taken shelter unto the lotus feet of, you know, we are speaking Guru, but still today I am not feeling any, I am not getting any feeling of Hari Bhajan, any bhakti. What can be the reason? First point is that, I already told many times before, when a jivatma, after getting, you know, after getting pain and pain and pain, suffering in this material world, after that, when that jivatma feeling, you know, fed up, and speaking fed up, feeling fed up, in that case, he want to search out the solution. In that case, sir, that time, tattva jigyasa can come inside me. Follow my point. Breakage of this, you know, siddhanta vichar making all problem. In that case, inside heart some question come. There is, you know, so much trouble coming in my life. And who am I? Why am I suffering so much? What can be the reason? Like from Bhagavata, you can get the example of that, you know, Tirandi Sannyasi. Tirandi Sannyas, he was businessman, Brahman, but businessman. After that he was paid up, because all gone, everything gone. Then after that somehow, he could realize, this must be an arrangement of Supreme Lord. So, today I am feeling little bit happy. So, Nunam Bhagavan Santushto. I mean, surely Supreme Lord is, you know, satisfied with me. Otherwise, why I am feeling this kind of detachment, growing detachment? It must be some reason. Supreme Lord must be. So, after that, he took decision to take sannyas. Prabhupada speaking, externally, everybody can take sannyas. You are also allowed to take sannyas. He is also allowed to take. Who is going to, because India is free, you know, freedom, enjoy. Whatever I like, I can do. Who is going to follow scriptural analysis? Who is going to follow, you know, rules and regulations set in, you know, who is going to follow? Main problem is that nobody like to follow rules and regulations. If somebody like to take sannyas, first of all, we should understand the quality of that man. Is there any quality so that he can take sannyas and maintain sannyas? Not that taking sannyas and after that making on nonsense and whole society going to spit on him, on Gaudiya society, it is not good. It is not good. Whole society going to spit on us. Simply because one thing, there is no idealism, there is no character, there is not, you know, nothing. That's why people like to hate us. That is the reason. Prabhupada speaking, without, you know, any reason, if only to maintain his, you know, life, everybody can give him pranami. So I can love puja patishta, I can get. Only for this reason, if somebody going to take sannyas forcefully, this kind of sannyas cannot allow him to get control over his sense organ. This kind of sannyas is useless. So external sannyas or white vest or red cloth, brahmachari is useless. External thing has some value, but all external thing all useless. It's more dangerous. Then, you know, common people leading their life is still good. But when they like to follow this kind of, you know, false track of renunciation, is more dangerous. That is why Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran going to express concern about this. It is written there, Sudraha pratigrahishvanti tapobesho pujivinaha. Sudraha pratigrahishvanti tapobesho pujivinaha. Those who are Sudra. Sudra means always expressing doubts, always expressing dissatisfaction. Shokam karoti shi Sudra. I am not getting patishta. Nobody going to, you know, love me. Nobody going to respect me. I am not getting enough money to control myself, maintain myself. All Sudra. Many times, I was bound to speak before that the situation in which I am put into by Supreme Lord according to my previous karma fall, I should admit it. I should accept it gladly. This is a symptom of Hari Bhajan. That is the symptom. Now actually, in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, we are going to get this, you know, indication. Actually, Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran also going to express concern on this point. Shudraha pratigvai shanti tapavesho pijivina. Those who are Shudra, they have no right to identify themselves even Vaishya. Even they cannot identify, they should not identify. What to speak about sannyas, but they are taking sannyas. After that contamination all there. Whereas a material person, a pure bhakta devotee, Rupa Goswami Pada expressing this kind of feeling. Also those pure devotees, they are also feeling this kind of, expressing this kind of feeling. You know, Rupa Goswami was speaking, Prabhu, if you like to put me into a case and set fire all around, still I can suffer. But still, please don't give me this asa sangha, material sangha. But we are taking it very casually. Ah, asa sangha, it can be there. Are you? You should take resolution to avoid asa sangha. If there is acharya, if there is sannyas, if you find that it is duplicate, if you all not going to think this point, then we can never rectify the situation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur expressing, you know, concern about it. If common people, they are not conscious about this point, to detect what is the genuinity, what is the falsity, otherwise there's big problem can be there. All contaminated, more than cancer, is going to eat up the vitals of our bhajan life. Very big issue. Shudraha pratigrahishanti tapavesho upinimina, tapavesho upijivina, if I can take sannyas, then everybody can give pranami to me, pay dandavat, it's good. I need not go to factory, need not go to cultivation field or need not start, oh, it's a big problem, I can do it. With this mood, everybody, almost everybody like to take sannyas. Tense, base, they need not, you know, suffer many, but they can, you know, lead their life. We are all responsible for that. Why we are not going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada? Why we are not going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, Rupa Goswami? That we are responsible for that. You know, we are responsible for that. Whom to blame? We are responsible for that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur expressing, you know, concern 150 years back, 60 years back. If the people, they are not, you know, get consciousness, you know, sachetanata, consciousness on this, about this point, then we cannot, you know, maintain this pure prema dharma, pure bimal prem dharma shown by Chaitanya, not possible, all contaminated. So, sudraha pratigyaishanti tapavesho pujivinaha, those are sudra. They are going to take base and they want to lead their life very peacefully, very nicely, without any hazard. That Shudra, always dissatisfaction, always, you know, demand, always, you know, dirty things inside. And this first line is Shudra Pratigyashanti Tapavishu Bhivinaha. And after that, you see, Dharmam Bhakshanti Adharmagya Adhiruro Uttamasanam. Those who are Adharmagya, like Duryodhan, Kamsa, they are taking sannyas with everything, acharyaship, and they are going to destroy the whole system. Dharmam Bhakshanti Adharmagya. Dharmam Bhakshanti, they are going to speak, give lecture on Dharma. They themselves not doing. They are stealing, they are doing all rubbish, they active, everything. You know, cheater. But they are doing everything, but sitting on a high helm, highest chair. So Dharmam Bhakshanti Adharmagya. They are Adharmagya, they don't know what is Dharma, Adharma, what to speak about Dharma, general Dharma they don't know. Social Dharma, you know, social Dharma, nothing. They don't know what to speak about Bhagavad Dharma. Dharmam Bhakshanti Adharmagya Adhiruro Uttamasanam. They like to climb in high seat of Vyasasana. They are going to sit on a high asana of a spiritual, you know, bhakta, speaker. That's why you can remember Jiva Goswami always speaking. Bhakta, swarago, nirago, divido, parikirte, taha. Bhakta speaker, you can, Bhagavad Bhakta, you can get two types of. One is having all the dirty things, anartha, everything inside heart, having desire to get name, fame, patishta, everything. And another, with a, you know, without any interest. No smell of any interest. No smell of any self-interest there. Only to carry out the order of previous Guru Varga, he is going to carry out his own duty as a speaker. So, Prabhupada speaking, my speaking Harikatha, my speaking, I am speaking same thing, sitting in Vyasasana with full resolution, I can take oath and speak, and speaking Harikatha only for the total satisfaction of previous Guru Varga and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nothing else. And speaking Harikatha, my speaking Harikatha, my speaking Harikatha, my speaking Harikatha is the topmost servitorship of previous Guru Varga. Not to earn any name, fame, position, nothing else. And Prabhupada, with a heavy heart speaking, until and unless one can stand on a neutral platform where there is no selfishness, until and unless if somebody is going to climb up to that point, that level, totally selfless service of Supreme Lord, he cannot serve as an acharya. We cannot expect an acharya can become a politician, more than a politician. Always playing politics, how to do, what to do, how to, you know, dashing, pushing, I can make my place in the world basis on Patishtha. They are more than political leaders. Openly political leaders, they are doing dirty things, but it's more, you know, more dangerous. Because at least we can know they are political leaders. So Prabhupada speaking, until and unless one can climb up to that neutral point, totally the selfless, you know, position, selfless, say without any self-interest, nothing, no trust. If one not going to climb that, he cannot act as an sadhu, act as an acharya. Acharya, actual sadhu, can excuse you hundreds of time. Not that he cannot excuse. Last day I was speaking, na kama rupam tapasinam. Excuse. To excuse somebody is not a big problem. A sadhu can do, but when there is a question of duplicity in bhajan field, Vaishnava Parad, Nama Parad, their Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, never going to make any compromise. If at all they are going to make, then there is duplicity with the Acharya, surely. Because they cannot make compromise with this. Suddha Siddhanta Vichar, you know, etiquette, all they cannot make. But they can excuse you all the time. All the time they can excuse you, but at all if you are interested to rectify yourself, that is very good. That is where they are ready to excuse you, but if you are ready to rectify your position, this is good. You know, this way, Prabhupada speaking, the root cause of this problem, whole world basis problem of devotional field, is that this point, adakshaja seva, aprakita adakshaja seva. How to do? Who is adakshaja? What is his position? What is my relationship with that adakshaja vastu, adakshaja vastu, Supreme Lord? How to do? What qualification should come inside me? And related thing coming, how to serve without taking diksha, you cannot serve. Now question again coming, whom to take shelter, where to get and take shelter of, taking shelter of Sadguru is a big issue. After that, my diksha, dibhugyan is at all I am interested to get. Because if I am less interested to get dibhugyan, if I am feeling problem in this society, and after that I am almost mad, I want to get some peace. With this mood, if I am going to approach a Guru Vaishnava, Papa speaking, most of us, just to solve, just to get a solution in this family problems, we are going to take shelter. No! If you are not interested to serve lotus feet of Supreme Lord, even still today you are not feeling any urgency to serve the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, Eternal Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord. Then how you, wow, diksha, what kind of diksha you can take? Because still today you are coming, you speaking, you are coming in front of Guru Vaishnava to take diksha. But your situation inside your heart is not going to permit you to take diksha. If at all Guru is Sadguru, still you cannot take diksha properly because you are less interested to do Hari Bhajan. So, the main question in Vedanta Sutta, Athauto Brahma Jigyasa. Sanatana Goswami speaking, Athauto Brahma Jigyasa, Sanatana Goswami speaking, same thing. Kyami kare more jare tapotroy iha nahi jani koiche mor hitoy. Who am I? How I am suffering so much? What is the solution? Who am I? This question is tattvajnan. Athato brahma jigyasa. Vedanta sutta athato tattva jigyasa smad bhagavad gita param speaking. At all you are not going to develop that kind of tattva jigyasa question. Then what use? Because ultimately you can take diksha, you can use your mantra, everything to get material glamour, position, everything. You can use it. You can remember the case of that Tidandi Sannyasi. Tidandi Sannyasi, when he could realize from heart, then he was, you know, very happy. Noonam Bhagavan Santushto. You know, still, I think today Supreme Lord is satisfied with me. Otherwise, why I am growing detachment from material things? Noonam me bhavan santushto jeno nitam enam dasam. So that I am, you know, I am reaching this kind of poor condition. It must be a very, very nice, you know, help, nice kripa of Supreme Lord. It must be so. After that, he took sannyas, not before that. And he took resolution to serve the lotus feet of Supreme Lord from heart. Prabhupada speaking, that is the success of your sannyas, white base and sannyas, anything you are taking. That is the success when you are going to take resolution that I can serve Supreme Lord from heart, wholeheartedly. That is the success of your sannyas. Only external danda and red coal, white cloth is not so important. But foolish people, they cannot understand because they are not sincere. They are not sincere. That's why they are not going, they are not going to get divine help. So it is their problem. That is the main problem. Actually, when you feel disgusted, after that you try to find out tattva. Who am I? How I am here in this material world? After death, where I can go? What is the solution? If I am going to put this kind of question, if I am going to put this kind of question in front of Tattvajnani Purush, in that case, a good symptom. Tadvidhi panipadana purivesana sevaya upadikshanti te jnanam jnani nastattadarshinaha. Tattvadarshi Mahapurush can give you Tattvajnan automatically. Automatically, but you are not getting due to duplicity there inside your heart. Kapat. That is why you are not getting. So, without achieving Diksha, without getting Dibbogyan, we are going to claim that Diksha is over. All over the world, this kind of problem going on. That's why, you know, huge amount of garbage in the name of Hari Bhajan, preaching, everything going on. So, who can check? Nobody like to check. Everybody busy with his own self-interest. You can remember the sloka I started with. I like to touch this sloka. Again I can go. What is dissatisfaction, suspicion? What is actual acharya, light bhakti siddhanta? If you follow bhakti siddhanta, if you can follow bhakti siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada and his unique acharyaship, I can put guarantee, nobody can cheat you. But I'm sorry, you are hearing so much countless harikatha about Prabhupada and his acharyaship, how far, how much I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada, what is present in our situation, and very shortly I am going to discuss about Prabhupada and Radhadasya. On Radhashtami day, I couldn't speak because time was limited. This way, you see, if we understand all these points, nobody can cheat us. But who is going to pay attention, full attention? Who is going to pay full attention? Casually they are hearing. Casually they are hearing. But they don't know. Many times, I told before, without taking perfect diksha unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, without, you know, sincerity, I cannot digest Shastra-gyan. I cannot digest Shastra-gyan. Shastra-gyan cannot get stability inside my heart. Unstable. Tattva-gyan cannot get stability inside my heart. So, useless. Without taking 100% shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru Vaishnava, nobody can get stability in Tattva-gyan. Some Tattva they can memorize. Some tattva they can memorize and speak to get clapping, but they cannot get feeling. The sloka I started with, I like to touch this. It is written, Jada Brahmam Brahmam Hari Rasad Rasagalad Vaishnavaganam Vaishnava Janam Babaishnavaganam. Jada Brahmam Brahmam Hari Rasagalad Vaishnava Janam Kadachit sankasyam sadanugamane shadruchi yutaha tada krishna britva tayati sanakoir maiko dasam sarupam vibhrano vimala rasabhogam sakurute. What is the meaning? Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. This is written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur dasamultatha. There. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, jada, when, in course of traveling these 14 worlds, by chance we meet with a pure Vaishnava who is full of transcendental love. Love, aprakito love, prema, harirasa, harirasa galat. The rasa, hari rasa, bhakti rasa is so much and overflowing, so much overflowing that you can realize. The external, you know, symptom also going to expose. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, when somebody having overflowing bhakti, automatically he, all his actions and activities, everything, all his speeches, all his speaking to you, all everything can expose something, secrets, which is there already inside your heart, which is nothing there inside your heart, all empty. You are going to express some, you know, you are going to open one exhibition, I mean, drama. How you can get power? So, if there is overflowing bhakti inside, you know, one, you know, Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, then automatically you can get through his activities, through his, you know, action and activities, it can get exposed. Yada brahmam brahmam harirasa galad Vaishnava janam. Kadachi sangpasan, in course of your traveling to 14 worlds, you know, if you get in touch with a pure Vaishnava who is full of prema bhakti, overflowing bhakti, kadachit, by chance, sangpasan, if you have the chance to see that Vaishnava somehow without any vanity, a sangpasan means at least in course of our traveling, you are at least going to discover your poor position and rank. Oh, so poor. My body, mind and this unstable society, at least. That is called sangpasan. Because if vanity is there, then sangpasan you can see. Like Chapal Gopal also got privilege to see Vaishnava there in Navadvipa. Chapal Gopal got the opportunity to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Devananda Pandit also got the opportunity to see Vaishnava. So what it concerned to us? That is not called sangpasan. They are looking casually as Sivas Pandit, hey, making disturbance. Throws Sivas Pandit, you know, they are going to throw Sivas Pandit from Bhagavad assembly outside because he is crying. And Mahaprabhu was so offended. He was bound to give punishment to Devananda Babu. Who is he to read Bhagavatam? I can tear up Bhagavatam. He has no right to touch Bhagavatam. But who is going to check whom? All duplicity going on, with Bhagavatam business going on, with disciple business going on, oh, deities business. They become angry with me. I know. The deity there in the temple, we are not going to serve the deities. The deity is going to serve us. Because if deity is there, that's why everybody giving donation, we are maintaining our world. Everybody become angry with me. But I am speaking about what Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada told. They should better fight with Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. You know? This way actually, sangpasan. So, Mahaprabhu was very offended. Mahaprabhu, when Chapal Gopal crying in front of Mahaprabhu, say, what you see? Today also I am going to touch, you know, aparad, you know, anartha, everything, but I am making background. I am making introduction, actually. When Chapal Gopal bringing to Prabhu, Prabhu, you please, you have taken incarnation to say, what you say? Idiot number one, I can never excuse you, infinity pure, you will have to suffer this way. What to speak about this life? You have done a great offense unto the lotus feet of pure Vaishnava, Sivas, you know. This way, Devananda Pandit got the chance to come out of this aparat. When? He got the opportunity, chance to serve Bhakeshwar Pandit. Otherwise, big problem was there. This way actually, Sarvamurti Jaja also, they couldn't realize. After that, with the association of Gopinath Acharya, developed some idea. After, ultimately, Mahaprabhu gave Kripa. Without Kripa, there is no way. This is Gaudiya Bhajan, whole day and night we have to cry, kipa karo, kipa karo, kipa karo. I am so weak, so weak, so weak, so fallen soul. If I think I am big acharya, who are you? Then I am a fallen soul. I am not acharya. The exclusive seva mood of a Vaishnava can prove his acharyaship. The exclusive, continuous and exclusive seva mood can prove his aprakita acharyaship. Not that I can demand I am acharya. You know, acharya, I know what to do. So this way actually in course of traveling these 14 worlds, at all if you meet with a Vaishnava and by that time at all if you are already feeling and that your position is very, very weak position, very, you know, poor situation, then, you know, this is not actually humbleness, but still, it's good. No vanity there. At least, you know, in fine form vanity there, it can go up by the association of Guru Vaishnava. So when they are at all going to meet with Guru Vaishnava, that is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Brahmando Brahmita Kuno Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bich. This same thing. Kadachi Sankpasyam Stadanugamani Sadruchi. If I have the chance to look at the character, actual efficacy, acharan, Siddhanta Vichara Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, by His mercy, if I already have the chance to look, then it is good. Then, what is written here? In that case, if you are going to meet with a pure Guru Vaishnava, in that case you can feel inspiration to follow that Vaishnava from heart. Stadanu gamane shad ruchi jitaha. He feel interested to follow that Guru Vaishnava. Like, I can give the example, one Krishnadas, one Brajavasi, Krishnadas, one Brajavasi. When Mahaprabhu was sitting in Imlitala, then Krishnadas, I can explain when Gaurpurnim coming, I can discuss. Now I am going to touch this point. From that side of river, Jamuna Nadi, coming back, and he is going to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, sitting at Imlitala. Oh my God! Krishnadas coming, is Bhujavasi, he's crossing the river by boat and coming and paying dandavat and speaking to Prabhu. Oh my God! Today, just today, today, I have this kind of chance because last night, in dream, I find one, you know, Dibba Jyoti, very powerful sadhu. He don't know he is Bhagavan, he don't know. He says, one powerful sadhu. Great effulgence coming out from his body. I saw in dream, and morning time he crossed the river and meet with you. What's that? Then after that, Krishnadas not going to leave Mahaprabhu at all, following Mahaprabhu. So this can be an example. If at all I have the chance to see Srila Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, to see the character and efficacy of Kesav Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, how I can live then? Even if you cut my throat, I cannot live then. I cannot live then, not possible. If I understand the glory of Prabhupada, how it is possible? If you want to kill me, still I cannot live Prabhupada. I cannot live Prabhupada, not possible. Because by His mercy, I try to understand something. What is the excellence there? You know? So, kadachi sankpasam stadanugamane sadruchi yutaha. When we come interested to follow that Vaishnava, stada Krishna Britta, then actually, if you are going to get Harinam Diksha, everything, tada Krishna Britta. Krishna Britta means Krishna Nam. Krishna Nam, you can, because Mahaprabhu speaking Hare Krishna, the Krishna. Krishnadas also speaking this way. But here, Tada Krishna Britta, it means, Krishna Britta means Krishna Bhajan, Abritti. When Guru Vaishnava is already going to show me, this way you will have to do Bhajan, follow this way, Harinam, this way, in toto, exactly I will have to flow. If I am going to follow Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava 50%, I am going to disobey, then I cannot get result. You know, all the time when Harikatha going on, you will have to feel that way. All the time you will have to feel. You cannot immediate. You will have to follow exactly. Not that Maharaj doing this, so we can do. So, Tada Krishna Britva. Krishna Britva mane Krishna Nam Abritti. Repeatedly, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, you can speak. Also, it means Krishna Britva. And how to do Krishna Bhajan, you learn from Guru Vaishnava. They are doing, you have to learn. Tada Krishna Britva. Repeatedly, you are practicing. Then, in course of your practicing, Tejati Sanakair Maikata Sam. Gradually, in course of your actual bhajan, you are going to cut your material bondage. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Tada Krishna Britva Tejati Sanakair Maikata Sam. Gradually, you can cut. Gradually. And very shortly you can discover all your anartha, everything gone. Tada Krishna Britva Tejati Sanakoir Maikadasam. From morning to night, what you will have to do? You will have to learn from Guru Vaishnava. You cannot follow your fanciful mind. If you follow your fanciful mind, because your fanciful mind is your director, you are going to follow him all the time. I can go for morning walk. If I say, don't do morning work, Maharaj, you are also doing, but you are doing mentally. You are doing, Maharaj, you are doing mentally all over Vrindavan, you are traveling. So I am going physically. Are Maharaj, I am doing, if you want to imitate me, if you have to understand my heart. If you go at all, don't go right side, go left side, and go up to Jogapitsi Mandir, and watch the, you know, Sudarshan Chakra of Jogapitsi Mandir, and come back. But after 7:30, in sunlight, you will have to go. So that you can get some, you know, sweat come out of your body. You will have to give some labor. Up to that point, 7:30, don't go. You will have to do Hari Bhajan. You know, that is also Hari Bhajan you can speak. Dham Parikram. You have to follow this point. So all the time you will have to do Kirtan Manita. You are going outside. Then how you can do? Outside you can meet with somebody. You can gossip something. You cannot do Harinam properly. So at all, if you are bound to go forcefully, then you have to go left side and go to the crossing. There you can see the Jogapitsi Mandir, you know, Mandir, Sudarshan and pay Chandavad. Prabhu, try to rectify my darshan every day. This you can do maximum. Wastage of time I cannot allow. You know, this way, Tada Krishna Britva Tejati Sanakair Maikadasam. So gradually you can cut the material bondage and you can gradually can understand what is bhakti, you can feel bhakti, you can feel a new platform on which untranscendental bliss can touch your heart and sarupam vibhrano, and you can gradually unveil, because now it is covered up. Bonded soul is not covered up, enveloped. Now sarupam vibhrano, the actual sarup of jiva can get manifested, bimala rasa bhagam sakuruti. In that case, and when anartha gone or everything gone, sarupam vibhrano, when sarup is totally exposed, then bimala rasa bhagam, bimala. Bimala means pure rasa bhog. Pure rasa bhog you can get, bhakti. Pure. Pure Vaishnava means those who are having. And those who are going to exchange five different kind of rasa, Shanta Dasya, Shaksha, Vatsalya, Madhur, or Popa speaking, in a very, very, you know, fine way they are doing. They are Vaishnava. Maybe their rasa is different. So, Sarupam Vibhrano, Bhimala Rasa Bhagam Sakurute. Gradually, second, he can also get the chance to do. We cannot confuse with material job, our health, you know, factors, mind factors, all we are going to confuse with. So, you should understand what is pure bhakti. But all the time, different kind of suspicion, doubts going to contaminate our hearts. Baba speaking, when you are going to stay with those So-called devotees, those are having, you know, some opposite conditions, they are going to hate pure Guru Vaishnava. They are just opposite of pure Guru Vaishnava. If you are going to stay among them, then in that case, never you can get bhakti. Shuddha Sangha, association is very important, top to bottom I am speaking, to cut your anartha also, adau, you know, Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shakshanam, etc. The sloka. And after that, different kind of mode of bhakti, you know, tapa, that day I was speaking about, you know, Anukulyasya Sankalpa Pratikulya Vibarjanam Rakshasya Siti Gaptitya Varanam Yatha. This all sloka you should understand. All. Everything you should understand. Then you can start pure bhakti, not before that. Very typical. Now, Maya always going to, Mala, Maya always going to cover our eyes. We, actually, if I give this example, like sun god is there in the sky, but we are saying today sun god is not there. You know, today no sun god is not there. Really so? Really so? Sun god is not there? Are Maharaj, sun god is there. Or somebody can speak that a cloud going to cover up the sun. Impossible. You know the size of sun god? You know, in comparison to this very, very tiny, this world, our earth, how big, you know, you can go mad. The, how it is possible for a piece of cloud to cover up the sun? So it is wrong. So that cloud going to cover up my eyes. This is perfect Siddhanta. That cloud, piece of cloud going to cover up my eyes, that's why I cannot see sun god. Same thing. Krishna is always there, we cannot see, because the cloud of Maya going to cover up our eyes, that's why we cannot see pure Guru Vaishnava, we cannot see Supreme Lord, we cannot see. We cannot see, because they are all self-effulgent. Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, all self-effulgent. So nobody can cover up sun god. Nobody can cover up Supreme Lord. You know, that's why in Gita Bhagavan also, there I am covered up by Maya. That's why nobody can see me. Because I am covered up by Naham Prakasami Jogumaya Samapritam. Nobody can see me because I am covered up by, you know, externally. We are expressing doubt, different kind of doubt, because material conception there. To know the sun god is quite impossible. How we can know? But distance, if you think, thousands of years after, we can get the sunlight, which is emitting right now. So, you know, you can calculate the distance, you know, of the sun god. After that, it is impossible to reach sun god. Because so much temperature, we cannot, and fusion reaction going on. Nuclear reaction going on. So huge temperature, you know, nobody can reach. How possible? You know, no metal, I mean platinum, uranium, any metal you use, if they are going within some range, they can get vaporized. Gold, uranium, platinum, rhodium, any metal get vaporized. So high temperature. Somebody, foolish people say, Maharaj, then how it is possible that sun god going to stay there? How possible? So much temperature. Are you foolish number one? Eh? Again, this concession of, you know, this, you know, apparent, you know, relative conception coming. If I put into 44 degree temperature, you can, oh, Maharaj, too hot, I cannot stay here. Then how you can go to sun god? By Surjalok, there are so many devotees, you know, devotees of sun god, they are going to Suryalok, Chandralok, is all false? No, Maharaj. They have that kind of tejomai sarir. They have that kind of body, tejomai body. So, we cannot understand. What is the sun god? Where is, you know, sun god? How is possible for sun god to stay there in, you know, how it was possible for sun god to come in front of Kunti Devi to give blessing? Oh, Maharaj, Durvasa Muni giving some mantra, and Kunti Devi, when he was just, you know, not married, virgin state, then Kunti Devi wanted to test that mantra given by Durvasa, and immediately she called sun god. Then sun god coming. After that she become very frightened. She said, no, I'm not. But you call me. You call me by mantra. That I am bound to come in front of you. What you need? I don't need. I know. I did nothing. You can go. Excuse me. No, my coming cannot go in vain. You know everything from Mahabharata. So you think it's false? Not. So all relative conception coming inside me. Now actually we'll have to understand that who can erase this kind of misconception? Only pure Guru Vaishnava can erase. Only if you are really, you know, 100% inclined. If there is no duplicity, 100% Guru Vaishnava can cut all misconception that is there inside your heart. Otherwise, nobody can cut. So, first of all, this issue coming, Guru Vaishnava is always very careful to save me from aparadha, because in the way of bhajan, somehow I get some kipa, I'm doing bhajan, and after that I'm growing false ego, not doing seva perfectly. And after that false, then after again I can do aparadha and take leave from bhajan. Thousands of such cases. After taking sannyas, even after become acharya, they are going up to that point, they can fall down, they can, all problem happens, you know. So first of all, Guru Tattva is that who can cut all my misconception. Dibhogyan mean there cannot be any misconception. If I am going to at all going to get, you know, if at all I am going to get the Dibhogyan, then how it is possible, Prabhupada speaking, how it is possible that still today there is no Dibhogyan there? How, Prabhupada speaking, after taking Dikkha so long period over, still today they are feeling some anartha everything? How it is possible? They are not feeling any inspiration to do Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan Seva perfectly? That's mean? That the defect is there with Diksha. Procedure was not perfect, or maybe the source from which you took what was not perfect, maybe you are not perfect, there can be so many reasons. You'll have to think out. I already told from Hari Bhakti Vilas many times, also I can discuss the, you know, on first, you know, the disappearance day of Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila my Shikshaya Usila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, I can discuss. Sarva Sangsaya Sangschetta Analasa Guru Rahit. Who is Guru, he can cut or ignorant from a root and can engage me in Guru Seva. Whatever towel can be there, whatever tough can be, I know it is very, 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 very typical. You cannot follow my instruction, what I am speaking. Because I am speaking all about Prabhupada. But still you will have to try. If at all your target is to get Nitya Seva. If at all you are interested to get the eternal service, if you want to get the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, then 100% you will have to follow it. Otherwise you need not follow. According to your inclination, you can get result. And next life, when you can get success, who can give guarantee, Maharaj? Who can give guarantee? So after taking Diksha, so much anartha, so much problem there, How it is possible? I mean, diksha was not complete. So you have to attain perfect diksha. Now you have received mantra from Gurudev, but the diksha is not perfect. Now you will have to get diksha perfectly by the help of Shiksha Guru, by hearing Harikatha. Diksha means sambandha again you can develop. After that you can cry for Sri Krishna, not before that. So, already I speak that sarva sansaya sanschetta, naschetta. Sanschetta means from the root cause, he can cut. Guru Vaishnava can cut all. All different kind of doubts and conception, misconception can cut. If I can get that kind of situation, position, then I can say that now it's okay. I can try to do Krishna Vayan properly. Otherwise, big problem all around. And aparat, Guru Vaishnava always going to give warning. A perfect Guru Vaishnava always giving us warning. Like Bhakti Pramod Purikishan. First of all, Baba, if you cannot do perfect bhajan, okay, still okay. Someday you can do. But don't try to do Vaishnava aparat. If you are going to do Vaishnava aparat, commit aparat, until lotus feet of Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Nam, Dam, then great problem. You cannot get any chance to get back your consciousness. Because somehow you are going to increase your consciousness, but now you are going to fall down again. So, I can give you one example. Like Dakha Pajapati, unnecessarily wanted to insult Shankar Bhagavan. Heavy insultment. Duryodhana wanted to insult Pidurji Maharaj. Dakha Prajapati wanted to insult Vaishnavanam Jatasam, both of them Vaishnav. Mahadadas Mahajana, weak Vaishnav. But they are so puffed up, so vanity, so, you know, false ego, they wanted to insult. They cannot see the glories of Guru Vaishnav. When, that's why Prabhupada used to say, when you are going to collect so much huge amount of money, then you can ignore surely, 100%. You can ignore Guru Vaishnava. Then you can feel, I am very important personality. If you are going to collect billions of dollars, unnecessarily, then you can see, then you can feel some false ego. You can ignore Guru Vaishnava. Trinadapi not possible. One sweet word they are using, that doesn't mean they are Trinadapi. That doesn't mean. So in that case, the situation is so poor situation, that if your Guru Padma going to make 5 months, 6 months, if there is four or five head of the members of the society, most of them are having billions of dollars. Suppose somebody acting as acharya is having so huge amount of money. If the situation of one mort due to corona, going to, you know, very bad, poor situation, then why they are begging from outside? Why they cannot take, why they are not going to help that moth? So poor, selfish situation. They have so much, huge amount of money. They can easily give this money, because that moth is also installed by Guru Maharaj, that deity also. Why you are putting that Maharaj into poor condition? He is bound to cry. Why? You cannot give? After your death, all your relatives, everything can, everybody, and all your demons, you know, the disciples, not disciples, demons, they can snatch and take out our money from bank and go. Why not you are going to help? You have so huge amount of money you have, I know, you cannot hide. Why you are not going to help that moth? That is also Guru Seva. But you don't feel it necessary. It is his moth. He is maintaining that moth. So selfish you are. You are going to act as acharya, demon. This is a situation, painful situation. Dakha Prajapati, he is puffed up. Dakha Prajapati is so puffed. He is going to insult Shankar Bhagavan. Because he is puffed up because of position. His position is very high. Given by Brahma. Prajapati, that's why he become very puffed up. He feel it necessary to insult Shankar. speak all rubbish, everything. But Shankar Vaishnavanam Yathasambhu not speaking anything and against. Let them speak. But after that, you know, Devrat Dakshadagga, total evolution took place. There are total, you know, that Jagya, Dakshadagga was totally destroyed. After that, you can remember what happened, you know, fourth canto. After that, all demigods, they are Brahma, everything. They, everybody going to, you know, approaching Shankar and going to beg for pardon. Shankar Bhagavan speaking, I never think of, because excuse is not, because sadhu, a sadhu, pure sadhu, what is the symptom? How you know he is sadhu? You can see, repeatedly you are making mistake. Still out of affection speaking, don't do mistake. Eh? This time you are making mistake, excuse, well, don't do mistake this way, repeatedly. Because the bonded soul, they can make mistake. What to do? But not that I have taken resolution to make mistake repeatedly and Guru Vaishnava can excuse. This mood is very bad, very bad, offensive, very. So now Dakha Pajavati, by the mercy of Shankar Bhagavan, by the mercy of Shankar Bhagavan, Dakha Pajavati got back his, you know, life, but with the head of a goat, you know. That head already gone, destroyed in fire, you know. So, then he was praying in front of Shankar Bhagavan. It is there, already you can go through the Sanskrit original, fourth canto you can find. Praying in front of Shankar, oh Prabhu, I couldn't realize your, you know, your position. I was foolish number one, I was bound to make mistake. But it is your duty to excuse us, Prabhu. This way, praying so humbly, with humble mood, we already see, we can see, that with very humble mood, they are going to pray in front of Shankar. But still, when I am speaking about the gravity of Vaishnava Aparat, if once Vaishnava Aparat done, it is very impossible to erase. Like, that's why I am giving this example. Then I can go to all in details about unearth everything, because I like to discuss in details, but time cannot permit, all the time limitation. So now that Dakha Pajapati, after out of his, you know, he was repenting all the time after their living body, Dakha Pajapati now with goat head, going to pray Shankar Bhagavan. Still then, there was some smell of jealousy. There was just some smell of jealousy and aparat, not totally cleared. Try to understand. There was a smell of jealousy and, you know, smell of hatred. Smell, not actually, but smell. You know, that's why that Dakha Pajapati could not get any respite. He was bound to take Chakshus Mannantar. In Chakshus Mannantar, different Mannantar there. In Chakshus Mannantar, that Dakha Pajapati took birth in the form of Prachetas Daksha. Prachetas Daksha, you know? Prachetas Daksha. And that time also, because that kind of aparad was there, a smell of aparad was not totally cleared. Smell of aparad was there, that's why the smell of Vaishnava aparad was there, still, as a residue. That's why he was bound to make aparad again unto the lotus feet of Naraji Maharaj. You can remember. Prachetas Dakha going to curse Naraji. You are foolish. You are not sadhu at all. You are not sadhu at all. Why? You are going to misguide our sons? Eh? You are sadhu? You are giving me pain? You are not at all sadhu. You are like sadhu. I curse you. You cannot stay anywhere for a long time. You know, 2-3 days cannot stay. You know. Then that Prachetas Daksha again going to curse Naraji Maharaj. You cannot stay in one place. You can become chanchal. Hare Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj is not at all chanchal. But you are going to curse, but it is one kind of benediction. Dakha Pajapati going to, you know, this Prachetas Dakha going to give curse. And Naraji Maharaj taking it, Paramahansa, going to take it as blessing. Well, if the more a pure Vaishnava can travel, the more they can have the chance to deliver common people. The more they can get the chance to travel here and there, and they can get the chance to deliver Varnatsa, that is their duty. What is the duty of a sadhu? To earn money from your pocket? To steal money from your pocket? Eh? No! To give everything. A body and life and everything, they are dedicated. They are sadhu. Their life and so everything dedicated unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord means they are going to show full dedication. That's mean a body and mind, all the dibba gyan of a sadhu, all going to help you. A sadhu can see, my life is you for you all. My life is you for you all. It matters little, you are going to do something, some seva, nothing, but the love there inside the heart of a pure Vaishnava, inconceivable. If you try to apply your dry philosophy, you try to, you know, put some logical interpretation, you cannot understand. So Naraji Maharaj, you know, was cursed by Prachetas Daksha. But Naraji Maharaj thinking it is one kind of blessing. I can run here and there. And I can deliver common soul. It is my duty given by Supreme Lord. Why is Sadhuguru Vaishnava, why coming here? To deliver bonded soul. If they are not doing that kind of duty, what they are doing? They are showing their sannyas base and done everything. This is their, you know, exhibition. What they are doing? That's why many times I told from third canto, you know, Janasya Krishnada Vimukhasya Daivad Adharma Silasya Sudukshitasya Anubruhayeho Charanti Nunam Bhutani Bhavyani Janadanasya. Many times I discussed. So it's very good, the pure Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, they can give darshans. Still it is good. Darshane Pavitra Karo Eita Margum Gangar parasihai pavitra, paschade pavitra, paschade pavam. When we are going to touch the water of Ganga, we can get purified. But when we can see a pure Vaishnava, instant we can get purified. You can test. Suppose you are feeling pain, this, that. Anyway, if you see a pure Vaishnava, as if some remedy, it's one kind of ready-made remedy. Yes, I'm not feeling so pain. Like I can give one example from the life history of my Guru Maharaj Leela. Guru Maharaj coming back from office, Port Trust, and he was in a hurry to reach the spot, you know, Ek Number Ultadegi Johnson, Bhaktivinoda Asan, to hear Harikatha from Prabhupada, because it is, Harikatha is going on from almost 6 o'clock maybe. Guru Maharaj is in a hurry, without taking anything, running, only change clothes, everything, and going to wear a, you know, chapal and covered up that on those days they were covered up chapal, front side cover, you know. Then whenever Guru Maharaj put leg inside a chapal, one scorpio bite. Oh my God! One scorpio bit, you know. Then Guru Maharaj, you know, throw that scorpio outside. And in this condition, without applying medicine, running to hear Harikatha from Prabhupada. So much pain, inconceivable. Guru Maharaj running. Cannot make any delay. Guru Maharaj running to hear Harikatha, reaching the spot after washing hand and leg, sitting by Harikatha. But Prabhupada watching, Prabhupada antarjami. Guru Vaishnava antarjami, na? They can feel. You know, Prabhupada watching, speaking Harikatha, but that young boy, young man, is feeling pain, something. After Harikatha is over, Prabhupada asking, today you are, I think you are feeling some pain. Then Guru Maharaj wanted to hide. After that, Guru Maharaj was bound to speak. Prabhupada, I was about to come here very quickly. I put my leg inside the chapel, then one scorpio bite. Really so? Eternal person of Prabhupada. So it's a must. You know, this kind of tremendous, you know, desire to hear Harikatha, it is also one kind of acharyaship. It is also one kind of acharyaship getting manifested from the very beginning. Because only we can expect from Parikshit Maharaj. You know? Vishnu Sabana Parikshit Abhavad Bhayasagi Kirtane. I told you, na? So this kind of tenacity, this kind of attraction for Harikatha is there. This kind of attraction there inside your heart? Today Harikatha is there, actually 2 o'clock. I have some other engagement. I cannot hear. I can hear after. You have that kind of attraction? Eh? You have that kind of attraction? So Guru Maharaj, you know, big Acharya, eternal Acharya. You need not make him Acharya. He is automatically, man, God made Acharya, Supreme Lord made him. You know, this kind of tremendous attraction for Guru Vaishnav Darshan, you know, tremendous attraction for Harikatha hearing can stop your all, you know, stop your all anartha. Or the game of your anartha can stop, can be stopped this way, you know. So I was speaking so many things about, you know, so many things I was speaking about. Adhikari at the rank of Vaishnava. But today I cannot get enough time because I will have to discuss about, you know, different kind of anartha. I was touching that day, you can remember. So tremendous love is there inside the heart of a pure Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava. They can see the whole world in relation to Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. Ravan can take sannyas externally. You know, Ravan can take. So what? Ravan can take sannyas. So what benefit we can get, expect from Ravan? So this way, all Vaishnava society, all over the world, irrespective of caste and creed, I am from this big society. My Guru Maharaj teach me to hate this Gauri Amat. Are this kind of, you know, hatred you are developing, cancer you are developing, infinity pure you cannot get bhakti. A sadhu is international. A scientist is international. And how you can confine them within this area? Ah, he is our sadhu, our raja. That thing, he is not acharya, he is not sadhu at all. Who is going to identify this way? Not at all sadhu. How? A sadhu is international. Whole world can take benefit from this sadhu. There is also politics. Ah, he is not from our society. Okay, you can die. You like to die, you can die. He is not from, sadhu is from Gauri Amar, so we cannot follow. All foolish people. This kind of politics is going on with, even with sadhu conception. Even we like to play politics with Bhakti Pumathuri Goswami. We like to play politics with Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is our status and position, you know. So I was bound to speak about different ranks of Guru Vaishnava pure. But today I cannot speak more about that. Maybe sometime I can speak. And I am very much interested to speak about Srila Prabhupada and Radha Anugatha. Srila Prabhupada and Radha Anugatha and his Radha Anugatha. I am very interested to speak because very secrecy there. About Yukta Vairagya, about very top secret seva mode there. So now you have to clear this one, you know. So many problems can happen in the way of your bhajan. If you are not alert 100%, who can save you? Guru Maharaj gone. Guru Maharaj gone. Vaishnava gone. All, everybody gone. Then if you think helpless, then it's very big problem. Because when Guru Vaishnava was there, were there, they wanted to help you, but you are, you know, you couldn't take help sufficient. Now again you are going to, you know, express indifferent attitude. If you are going to, you know, going to lose this chance, you will have to cry, you will have to cry, you will have to cry whole day and night. You cannot get any help. How you can get? When Nityananda Balaram himself going to arrange so that you can get some clue of Hari Bhajan, pure Bhajan. Yes, Nityananda, it is the 100%, 100%. It is the arrangement of Nityananda. It is the arrangement of Balaraji Maharaj, Adi Guru, Shankar Bhagavan. They are Guru Tattva. They are going to help us to have the chance to have Harikatha, Kirtan, everything. Still today, we are not sincere enough to avail this opportunity, which is a rare opportunity. Then how to? So again, I can discuss about the different kind of, you know, different kind of, you know, rank of pure Guru Vaishnava. I was speaking last day, actually, you can remember. Tibhuvano Vibhava Hetavi. You know, Tibhuvano Vibhava Hetavi Opi Akunta Sruti Rajitatmo Suradivir Vimigrat Na Chalati Bhagavat Padar Vindat Labo Nimeshardham Opi Ya Sa Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava? I was speaking, na? I know, maybe 15-20 days before I was speaking. When, you know, Abvartito Tadatasme, I was speaking about, you can remember, Kali. And if you find some Guru Vaishnava Acharya, Sannyasis busy with all material thing, money, position, rank, everything, immediately we have to throw him and take shelter of a pure Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, in infinity period, you cannot get chance. So, avaishnava mukhopadishtam mantrena niram bhajat punasya vidhina grahet vaishnavad guru. Again, you will have to, because no use. I have taken dikha maharaj, so no use. You have taken dikha. You are busy with false ego. You are watching position, status, rank, everything. You are less interested about getting the bhagyan. So you took decision to the degree. Whereas I already told Bhaktivinoda Thakur Swami, oh, gentlemen, don't be busy with this issue. Ah, you will have to take the committee. No! Bhaktivinoda Thakur Swami, no, wait and see. Wait and see. Try to keep patience. It is an arrangement of Balaji Maharaj. If your sincerity is 100%, accordingly, divine help you can get. You can get the darshan of Sadguru. How I got the darshan? The day I took rest night time at the bank of Ganga, Navadvip, morning time across, I got some clue night time. You know, in a dawn, you know, at 3 o'clock, 3:30. After taking bath in Ganga, I crossed the river, went to Chaitanya, everything, all darshan. After that, I meet Guru Pad Padma. Same day, how it was possible? And this conception was there inside my heart. My Gurudev is very experienced, very, you know, knowledgeable personality, very Dibya Gyan there, very great, you know, sadhu, aged, really so. Really so, I find this. So, nobody can cheat me. Nobody bring me. Automatically, by the mercy of, you know, Nityananda, I got clue from one picture in Vrindavan, you know, bookstore. So this way, all the way, you will have to wait for the keep up Nityananda. Don't try to apply your doership. Now I can find out, hey, yeah, it's very big, you know, Acharya, thousands of people taking diiksha. So I can go. So you can go as you like. But if you like to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then please wait and watch. Situation can speak you. Situation can give you indication who is your guru. It's a must. That's why I was bound to explain that so you can remember. You know, abhartitos tada tasme istana nikale dadau dutam panam striyaha suna yatra dharmo chaturvidaha punascha jachamanayo jato rupam adat prabhu tato amritam madam kyamam tato amritam madam kamam rajo vairancha panchamam amuni amuni panchasthanani hi adharma prabhavakali उत्तरेण दत्यानि नवसत तन्निदेशकित अथैतानि न सेवेतो बुभूषः पुरुषो कचित विशेषतो विशेषतो धर्मशीलो राजा लोको लोको लोकोपतिर गुरु इफ ए किंग लाइक राजर्षि लाइक परीक्षित महाराज लाइक युधिष्ठिर महाराज लाइक अम्बरीश महाराज Like, you know, Janak Maharaj, they are not going to take undue advantage of the opulences already there in their custody by the mercy of Supreme Lord. Dhuva Maharaj, Pallad Maharaj, immense, you know, so huge opulences, but still they are not going to misuse it. You know, Ambarish Maharaj always used to always wanted to use it for Krishna Seva. Now it is a special instruction given by our Guru Varga. Those who are busy, I speak all the slok. If at all, if you find those who are busy with these things, which is prohibited, already Parikshit Maharaj giving them, giving Kali free access over those things. So actually pure sadhu they should avoid it. Arthamanartham bhavayo nitam. You can sing in front of public, but you cannot feel. Too much amount, huge amount of money can put us in the influence of Kali. We don't need. We at all by the mercy of Bhagavan Supreme Lord, if we by Madhukuri not putting pressure on some, if we can arrange this seva, little with book publications and a place by, this we can do. If at all by the mercy of Nityananda. We cannot, you know, put pressure on, you know. According to their consciousness, according to their dedication, they can try to extend their help. It's one kind of seva. They should feel inspiration. Because if after taking diksha, if you are not feeling inspiration to do Guru Vaishnava Bhagavat Seva, then surely your diksha is not perfect diksha. So those who are going to avoid this kind of places where Kali already having his influence, such genuine guru is almost rare. Who can give clear conception about the absolute truth, absolute way, standing on absolute platform. It is still more rare who can accept that kind of tattva gyan. It is still more rare. I know Sadguru is rare. I know. But it is still more rare who can accept this kind of tattva gyan. There is a situation. How we can keep continuous flow of tattva gyan, how we can keep continuous flow of, you know, our sampradayik vaibhav, you know, because sampradayik vaibhav means bani vaibhav. If bani vaibhav is missing, then everything missing. If bani vaibhav is missing, then everything is, we can get lost. We cannot, you know, identify ourselves as a Gauriya devotee. If everybody is less interested to follow, yeah, Maharaj is too tough, it's impossible. Are you too tough mean? What do you mean? Eh? Bhagavad Bhajan itself, you know, if you are at all interested to, otherwise you are going to increase garbage. If you need the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, if you need eternal service. If you want to enter into, otherwise you are going to take darshan of Vaishnava, like, you know, Devananda Bandir also took darshan of so many Vaishnava, but that was not actually Chapal Gopal. You know, that is not darshan actually. So that day, last day, I was speaking about how to understand how many anarthas, how different way branches of anarthas, because without eliminating anartha, we cannot start actual Harivajan. If you know, anartha is there, how it is possible for somebody to act as an acharya? Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking from Bhajan Rasya, Maya Mugdhasya Jivasya, Gyo Anartha Chaturvidaha, Hriddau Vallo, Hriddau Vallancha Paradho, Asatishna Tattva Vibra. So, four different kind of branches of Anarthas, and what is that? Asatishna, Asatishna, Hriddau Vallo, Aparad, Asarub Vibhram. Asatishna, these four different, and each of them having four different branches. Asatishna having four different branches. Hriddau Vallo, weakness of heart, have four different branches. You know, Aparad is also four different branches. Sarub Vibhram also four different branches. Oh, we can discuss today, try to understand at least. After that, if there is at all any question, we can put in front of Guru Vaishnava to understand clearly. Okay. With full attention, we are going to hear this point. Because anartha, if anartha is there, with anartha, it is quite impossible to start Hari Bhajan. After eliminating anartha, we can start Hari Bhajan. From the root cause of anartha, we will have to eradicate. Then we can do Hari Bhajan. Because Hari is not an object of the, you know, which is, Hari Bhajan is not an object within this 14th world. Not an object which is available in this 14th world. Harir hi nirguno shakshat purushaha prakriti parehe sa sarvadrik upadashta tang bhajano nirguno bhavet. Those who are going to do bhajan of Hari, who is nirgun, nirgun mane beyond any material influence, beyond any influence of three modes of nature, sattva, rajo, tamo. That though if Hari is beyond any influence of sattva, rajo, tamo, three modes of nature, those who are going to worship of that Hari, they also need to get that kind of platform, attain that platform. They should also go up to that point. I mean, beyond any material, you know, bondage, influence of three modes of nature. Harir hi nirguno sakshat prakriti pare. Hari is not an object which you can find in this 14th world. It's a transcendental. So, Parikshit Maharaj, to Parikshit Maharaj, Shukdev Goswami is speaking, that Hari, in the form of Paramatma, watching everybody, what you want to do, what kind of expectation, what kind of dirtiness there, all Hari going to watch us. Sa sarvadrik upadrashta is watching us, what we are doing, what is our, you know, desire, what is our, you know, planning, or watching. So, sa sarvadrik upadrashta, if you want to do bhajan of Hari, so you will have to, you know, elevate yourself up to that level. Otherwise, you cannot start Hari bhajan. So, with anartha, nobody can do actual Hari bhajan. Now we are practicing. We are hearing Harigatha, practicing Harinama, but with a resolution, but shortly we can cut all anartha. We are very much interested to enter into actual Hari bhajan. Hari bhajan means we want to satisfy Hari, Guru, Vaishnava from heart. We are not going to calculate how much satisfaction I can get out of this activity because I am not a businessman. A businessman can always calculate, I am doing this, what return I can get, not that. So they cannot do Hari Bhajan, impossible. So, Sarubhrubham, Sharup, Sharup Brahm, but Tattva Brahm is also four kind. Because there I already told Satattva, Jives Sharup Vai Krishna Nitya Das, they are not going to feel that way. Satattva, there is mistake. They are applying their assumption, calculation, logical interpretation, they are applying. But Satattva, your own Tattva of Jivatma. Jive Sarup, in unveiled condition, Jive Sarup hai Krishna Nitya Das. And more mature state when Jiv can understand the full glories of the lotus feet of Nanda Nandan Krishna, he can feel the rasa, everything. In that case, Mahaprabhu is going to teach us that we can identify ourselves. Which way we can identify? We can say, Prabhu, actually, first of all, we can say, Nayanam Gala Sudhaya Vadam Gadavya. And after that, we can say, Prabhu, I have no identity. Gopi Bhartu Rukpada Kumalayara Dasu Dasanu Dasaha. Is the topmost realization of Rastatta. But before that, there is also rasa. There may be somebody interested about those rasa. They cannot go, but Mahaprabhu teaching us. There is the Asrishya Bhapadatam Pinastumam Adarsanat Marmatum Karatuva Jata Tathava Vidhatulam Padam Matpana Nathasu Swayvenapara. This is my Prabhu. He can give me any kind of treatment, bad or good. It matters little. I like to get his kripa. This is the mood of Rupanuga devotee, Raganuga devotee, especially Rupanuga devotee. And because Raganuga open term. And when you are feeling that kind of pain, like Mahaprabhu speaking now, Mahaprabhu crying and speaking in front of Krishna. Mahaprabhu crying heavily and speaking in front of Krishna. Nayanam galadasudharaya badanam gadagadurudhaya gira pulakair nichitam vapu kadatava namagone bhavishvati kadatava namagone bhavishvati. Through this point, Mahaprabhu giving an indication that to get into Raganuga bhajan, Rupanuga bhajan, you will have to take shelter 100%. Namasraya kari jatane tumi thakoho yapano kaje. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur teaching us, Mahaprabhu teaching us, we will have to take absolute shelter. We will have to take absolute shelter of Nam Prabhu Charan. Nam Prabhu Charan? Lotus feet? Yes. Nam Prabhu also have lotus feet. I can discuss someday. Lal Nam Prabhu is, you can say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. But he say Radha Govinda. Lotus feet you can see. You know, in Kalna, Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj used to worship only Nam Prabhu. Some devotees are giving ornament to Nam Prabhu, is putting ornament in front of Nam Prabhu, always doing worship of Nam Prabhu. And someday some thief stolen. Then Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, Sevak speaking, Baba, all the ornaments of Nam Prabhu gone. Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj laughing. Maybe Nam Prabhu don't like to wear it. Okay. After some day, that thief who took away all ornaments, everything, going to keep everything in front of deity, sometime in a suitable time, put everything and gone. Then Sevak speaking, Baba, what happens? All ornaments of Nam Prabhu already come back again. Then Babaji Maharaj laughing and speaking, maybe a Nam Prabhu want to wear it. Okay, you give him. This is their mood, you know. They can see Nam Prabhu mean Radha Govinda Jugal Kishore, nothing else. So now I am going to touch this point, very important point. In your own tattva, Jive Sarup, own tattva vibram, paratattva means absolute tattva, it is your all jivatma. If they can feel that they are the eternal servant of Krishna, satattva, Paratattva means absolute tattva regarding that, you know, Parabrahma tattva. And Sattva Sadhana tattva. Sattva Sadhana tattva means, I can give example, in Chaitanya Bhagavad you can go, you can find, that Mahaprabhu, as a teacher, you know, guru, teacher, going to present Bangladesh, you know, at present it is Bangladesh, that time it was India, Purva Bengal, East Bengal. They are actually for giving giving lesson about Sanskrit grammar, you know. But there are so many people coming in front of you to know, you know, Sadhu Sadhana Tattva. Tapan Mishra, you can remember. Tapan Mishra coming in front of, you know, him and Mana speaking in front of Prabhu. Prabhu, I was in confusion for a long time. Prabhu, I was in great confusion for a long time. How to receive, whom to receive, what is the Sattva Sadhana Tattva, I cannot calculate. And everybody is going to give wrong idea, misconception. But especially today, yesterday night when I was sleeping, in the morning time, almost in the, you know, night break, you know, I find some indication in dream that Nimai Pandit coming from Navadvip, he is Parabrahma Parathpara Akhileshwar. You can go to him, he can give indication about, or in total, about Sattva Sadhana Tattva. That's why he come to you, in front of you. How to do Hari Bhajan? What is Sambandha Gyan? What is Avidya Avidya Prajan? All, whole world in confusion. Whole world in confusion. Those who are not going to follow Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada and Bhakti Minuto, 100%, they are in confusion. Blindly, I can say, those who are not going to follow Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, they are in confusion, they cannot understand. Because everybody can misguide you. They want to make their own society, position, rank, you know, glamour. Oh, I am so great, Acharya. Huh? This way. So, Satatte personal, you know, all Jivatma, they are personal tattva, satattva, and paratattva, sadhya-sadhana tattva, and virodhi tattva. What is just opposite of bhajan? Negative. If I am not going to have a clear idea about negative things, I cannot get solid foundation in positive bhajan field. That day I was speaking, huh? If I have no idea about darkness, then how I can understand the exclusive glory of light? To understand the unique glory of light, I must have negative ideas. Oh, this is our darkness. This is a poor condition. This is light. This way I can get clear. So always try to understand why our previous acharya speaking this way. It is not confusion. It's very clear. If we don't understand what is positive bhakti, we can do bhakti in the name of bhakti. That day I was speaking, na? Yeah? Suti, siti, pura, nadi, pancharatting, viding bina, vaikantiki, harer bhakti, utpataiva kalpate, it is all rubbish. In the name of bhakti, in the name of devotion, everybody in confusion because they are not getting clear idea. So this kind of what is negative, sattva sadhana tattva, and virodhi vishaya, or you should understand very clearly to get solid foundation in the on the platform of devotional line, pure devotional line. And again, you know, this, and I'm not going to explain in details, more details, not time cannot permit. So today I'm going to touch, maybe next day, but immediately next day, mean 30th, I cannot touch this point because Haridas Thakur Nirjan, disappearance and Sila, my Siksha Guru Sila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj's disappearance day, so I can discuss. So, next, you know, 30th I cannot discuss, also first I cannot discuss, 30th actually I think 30th is Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I will have to check up, it is appearance day, I think, I will have to check, yeah. Yes, actually. So, Jiva Goswami Pad and I can check up. Okay. So, I confuse. So, Here it is written that Asatrishna, you know, unusual desire, which is no link with Krishna Bhajan, which has no link with Krishna Bhajan, that is called actually unusual desire, unusual expectation, Asatrishna. Is Asatrishna also four kind of Asatrishna desire, unusual? Unusual desire going to put us in trouble. We cannot get Krishna Bhakti. We can never get the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. It's not possible. So this way, there can be a big problem. If we don't understand this point, there's a big point we can get. Big problem in our life. So, on 30th, actually, Jiva Goswami Pada Abhirbhav and Bhaktivinoda Thakur Abhirbhav. I am right, actually. Sometimes I forget. Right, actually. So you see that there is Asatrishna, unwanted demand, unwanted desire, contaminated, you know, heart. It is also four types of contamination can be there due to this Asatrishna. Four kind branches there. Oihik, meaning this life, I like to... This life, I have different kind of desire which has no link with Krishna Bhajan. Is Asatrishna, Oihik Parotrik. Oihik Parotrik, meaning after my death, I like to get name and fame. Everybody can give slogan, Jai Ho, Jai Ho, Jai Ho, Jai Ho. So I like to arrange that kind of situation. I'm so clever. So Oihik Parotrik. Eshana, Oihika Parthi Eshana. This life I like to arrange so much solid foundation about my Pratishtha. Oihika Parathrik, Parathrik, after my death I like to get Oihika, you know, Parathrik and Oihika Eshana, Bhutikam. I like to get Bhutikam and Vibhuti, Hana, Jog Vibhuti, different kind of Ashtanga Yoga, it's all, you know. Different kind of vibhuti. That day I was speaking, na? One friend speaking in front of other. And one man, you know, he is speaking in front of his friend. I have done bhajan for 25 years. What is your achievement? Now come with me. And after that, he is going in front of at the bank of a river, and he is walking over the water. Friend is laughing. 25 years you are misusing. I only by paying 2 rupees, you know, 2 rupees. Previously it was 50 paisa. I can cross river. Why should I pay? At all, if you like to do Krishna Bhakti, you can give you energy. But no Bhakti, he are going to give you energy. Somebody going to give energy for the reason, martial art. Judo, karate, kung fu. Who, they are practicing from childhood. Hey, Maharaj, what is the utility? Maharaj, you know, don't know. If some group going to attract, then I can get a... Maharaj, in whole life, there is no such guarantee that everybody can attack me. Then why should I take preparation for that? Unwanted desire. And going to give life. And if somebody going to fire me, only one gun cell is sufficient for him to kill me. So, why should I hoo-ha, unnecessarily going to give energy? Foolish number one. So this way, no utility. So ohi, you know, Parathik, Ohik, Aishana, Bhutikam, Vibhutikam, and somebody, Jog Vibhuti, like to get Jog Vibhuti, can enter into body and understand what is your desire, opinion, you know, everything. Jog Vibhuti, different, can know, can see everything from long distance, you know. Yes, it's possible. One sadhu, one yogi, you know, coming back from Himalaya after Jogsiddhi, he is doing bhajan in a village under a tree, banyan tree, big banyan tree. By chance, there was one murder case. And that murder case was just happened, just murder was just a few, you know, maybe, you know, and 200 meters away, maybe, not long distance. And police came, Police is also making inquiry about that, you know, murder case, going to arrest that yogi. He was taken in jail. So, and everybody, you know, interested, how sadhu is doing yogi? How? The yogi, then they are in court asking, hey, you know who killed? Yogi say, yes, I know. Who killed? Yogi going to say, he killed him. Then everybody there is great, you know, agitation. The lawyer and the, you know, judge speaking, how it is possible you are speaking lie? You are speaking lie? But no, sir, I am not speaking lie. He is a, how it is possible? My lord, how it is possible for a man to stay almost, you know, long distance, 500 meters or, you know, from distance, how it is possible for him to watch this so long distance, how it is possible for that yogi to understand this? Then yogi watching outside the, you know, outside the, you know, the where this is going on the court, outside court, watching outside and giving instruction to that lawyer. You please go outside. You please go out. Why? Well, you go outside. If you have any doubt about my strong, you know, strong vision power, if you can go outside, you can go there, very long distance. There you can find a row of ant going up, red ant going up. It's from here outpost. You go and check up. You go and check up. He go and check up, really so. A line of, you know, ant, red ant going up in a row upside. Then the lawyer and all the, you know, judge was bound to accept. Yes, it's possible. So it's possible to see everything. Shankaracharya leaving his own body, going to enter into the body of the dead body of that king, South India, you know, everything. I'm not going to speak in details, time cannot permit. After that, wanted to get the knowledge about the secret, you know, karma. You know, this way, everything possible. By yoga, I myself know. In my life also, I am not going to pass lecture. I went to different Himalaya place long ago, not today actually, long, long ago, by the permission of Guru Maharaj. Even Gomukh is the extreme point. After that, nobody liked to go. Even after that, the big, you know, Himalaya hill, after the big, you know, some kilometers up, I went there. Tapovan there. Tapovan means Dibba Bhumi, heavenly plane. There one yogi was there, one Mataji, two, three yogi there, that's why Simlai Baba, and other yogi, other Mataji. She speaking, I am from Karnataka, for the past, you know, 50 years, I am doing yogi. You are not going outside? No, nothing. You never like to see Kedarnath, Badrinath. Mataji speaking, I go. Then we understand how she is going. By Jogbal, he is flying by Jog power. He is going there, take darshan. She is speaking, sometime I like to take darshan. I go and take darshan and come back very quickly. Really? Really? Yes, he is going there. You know, Kedarnath, Badrinath, take darshan and come back quickly. I saw her, just like Kalima. Oh my God. You know, this way by Jog Vibhuti, somebody out of his bhajan want to, but Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, never in their whole life, they never wanted to show any Jog Vibhuti in front of public. Whereas it was automatically there. That kind of Jog Vibhuti power was automatically there with them. But Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, they never wanted to show that kind of, because it is prohibited. It is against pure devotion. Guru Padma was bound to rectify one blood cancer patient. Totally. He, you know, given, doctor speak open order. Now it's up to you. You have to call Supreme Lord. You are going to die. Nobody can save. But they are crying in front of Guru Maharaj. Guru says, okay, actually you will have to call. No, you will have to give. Repeatedly they are disturbing. After that, Guru Maharaj told, okay, you do it. You can get dust particle from Seva Kunch in the night time, 2 o'clock. And this nakshatra, star position, you have to collect water from Jamuna, then come to me. Then Guru Maharaj was bound to give. But Guru Maharaj was not at all ready to give this kind of, this joke siddhi. This kind of, automatically, those who are, you know, like I give Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, one day going to, you know, drive away one goat. But one man going there, he is going to beat me. After that, then a Jamindar, landlord, took information. Well, really so. Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, his body is there in Kalna, but he is driving in a goat from Tulsi garden in Govinda Mandir. Really so. Pass away. This is very cheap thing. So we should not expect this kind of joke vibhuti, nothing. We cannot expect even people can give us garland, wash our lotus feet. No! No! The day they are going to do it, we can stop Harikatha. The day they are going to wash lotus feet, you know, give garland, that is the last day I can stop Harikatha. I don't like. You know? So, today I will have to finish up to this point. I can speak in details. So, Oihik, in this very life, in this life, they like to get some power, everything. This, you know, Oihik, Paratrik, after their body is gone, you know, they like to get some power. You know, this way, Bhuti Vancha, after they are going to get some Vibhuti, and after the Mukti, they like to get Mukti. So, Bhakti you can never get until and unless you are interested to serve a pure devotee who is already engaged in seva. Because Mukti means salvation, salvation means they like to attain that position, Nirvana, where no problem can touch. What is concern to us? Automatically those who are going to do so Bhakti, automatically they are going to get that kind of, you know, thing. No problem can touch there. So I can discuss all in details in the next Harikatha. But up to that point, we'll have to repeatedly understand what we are going to hear clearly to understand all from whole point. So try to remember Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Sai, don't try to forget him. Vrishabhanu suta daitanu charam charana sitarenu darastamaham mahatadbhuta pavana sakti padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam vancha kalpadurvasya kripa sindhu bhavacha patitanam pavana bhavishnabhyo namo.